Yeah, go ahead.
So the Kenya Demographic Health Survey in 2003 came up with the fact that the doctor patient ratio in Kenya is 1 to 10,000, which means that for every 10,000 Kenyans, there's only one doctor serving them. The majority of these specialists are within the capital city, Nairobi. While we know that the majority of the population in Kenya lives in rural settings. So this device allows people living in rural areas to access healthcare from urban-based specialists. The idea being that this device in a remote area, say like where I'm from, Kisumu Rural, the patient goes to the station, is hooked up to this health monitoring machine, and they take their temperature, their blood pressure, can monitor their heart activity, their lungs activity, it can do everything. And the doctor based in Nairobi can get these readings transmitted to him, and he can ask questions to investigate further and come up with a diagnosis remotely. And then from there, you can come up with a treatment plan for the patient. It's medical in terms of giving the patient drugs, it's a term of lifestyle adjustment for diseases such as diabetes and things like that. You can now transmit this information back to the patient all the way in Kisumu Road, in Nairobi.
Yeah.
So the patient saves on time, the time it would take to come to Nairobi to see the specialist. Saves on money, saves on lives. Because as we know, the current system in Kenya is based on a system called referral, where a patient starts from the primary center, which is the dispensary, moves on to the district hospital, on to the provincial hospital before reaching the national hospital. These are different levels of care. So now the time to take a patient to get from Kisumu Rural all the way to Nairobi, we end up with patients who are in the end stages of their diseases. So this would save lives. I think this is revolutionizing healthcare.
So as in, it's already alive?
It's in the initial stages. Safaricom is partnering with the government of Kenya and is proposing it to a number of private hospitals as well to take this up, to enable them to provide healthcare to the rural.
Now, as a doctor, are you going to register to the system, or how are you going to come about it?
You see, this facilitates doctors to offer their services to a broader base of Kenyans. So, Safaricom provides the service, and the client, which is the patient, is on one end, and the service provider, which would be the healthcare professionals, are on the other end. So Safaricom is providing a medium that will link the healthcare providers with the patients on a broader level.
Yeah, that looks nice. So there will be a process where guys will be registering some verification of quality of service you're providing.
Definitely. For every health service that's offered, there's a regulatory body. If it's, for example, drugs, there's the Pharmacy and Poisons Board. If it's medical services, there's the Kenya Medical Practitioners and Dentists Board. So it only follows sense that such services would have to fall under the audit for such institutions to ensure that the quality of care that patients are getting is not compromised through the use of this medium. In fact, chances are the patients will be able to access a higher standard of care because they'll be able to consult professionals not just within their own country but abroad as well.
Oh yeah. So now, what interface does the user get?
Regarding the technical aspects of the system, I'm a healthcare provider, so I can only speak about the health-related aspects of this.
So you can't tell what the doctor sees on his end and what the...
The doctor sees the patient.
On screen?
Yeah, on screen. There are microscopes available. There's an inspection device available. So if I need to have a closer look at something, I just zoom in. If I need to monitor something, I just ask the nurse who's on site with the patient to give me access to that particular area. For example, stethoscopes can be linked to the device. And you can listen to the patient's heart, and the doctor on his end has earphones, and you can hear the beating of his heart, and you can just tell the nurse, move it to the left, move it to the right. You can actually come up with a diagnosis of this disease.
Oh, so the setting in this case is like a photo, a booth or something where people will have to go and access the services, and the service provider is remote in another area, but there's obviously the points where collection of this data is.
Yeah, no different from a dispensary or a district hospital. Mm-hmm. In fact, that's where these devices would be best suited, because it's at that point where you already have the primary healthcare providers such as nurses and clinical officers. And these are the people whose services will be invaluable in making a project such as this viable for the future.
Cool. I'd say that's good.